All right, guys. So you just got a new puppy, or you are...
Congratulations.
Very, very, very soon getting ready to bring a new puppy home.
Congratulations. That's really exciting. Puppies are always exciting, and we love puppies.
But yes.
Even more than that, we love helping you with your new puppy, because most people, when they get a new puppy, have lots of questions, especially if it's their first new puppy.
And we're going to give you the three things that you should be doing first when you bring that puppy home.
Yes. So the first thing you want to think about is creating a routine for your puppy. We talk about routines a lot, and we want to make sure that we differentiate between a routine and a set schedule. We don't want to make a schedule that the puppy is adhered to and they expect, well, breakfast is at 6 a.m. and if it doesn't happen at 6 a.m. every single morning, I'm going to cry my little heart out and cause a big fuss.
Because they will.
Right. Or they expect, well, every evening at 5 p.m., mom comes home and lets me out of the crate to go to the bathroom. Well, when that becomes the expectation, then if you get a flat tire, or you have to stay late for work, or you grab dinner instead of coming home and cooking dinner, your puppy goes, whoa, whoa, whoa. I thought I got let out at exactly 5 o'clock. Yeah. I can't hold it any longer than that. So that's how setting up a schedule that's super strict and structured will potentially set you up for not the most successful situation, especially with a young puppy.
So the other parts of the routine itself, they're going to include kind of when you're going to be feeding, give or take, when you're going to be doing potty breaks, when they're going to have crate time because you're at work or you're going to town to run errands or whatever you have that set up for. And then it's also going to need to include training time and play time, exercise time.
Yes.
So all of those things are going to have to be fit into your
routine,
the way that works best with your family and your situation. Now, granted, you're going to have to make some changes to your lifestyle when you bring home a new puppy, most likely. But at the same time, you want that to be as close to what fits. You shouldn't completely uproot what you're doing. You should be able to work the puppy into your life and your situation through this routine.
Yes, and we typically like recommending using meals for training sessions so you can fit that into your routine, because it's important that puppies learn to work for their food and work for their meals so that they don't get picky grazing, I only feel like eating a little bit now and then I'll come back to it and eat a little bit later type of behaviors, especially when we're developing hunting dogs.
100%. Do we have anything else on routines?
I like to mention with routines, when you're starting crate training, people sometimes make the mistake that when they're home, their puppy is out with them constantly, and when they're away, the puppy is crated. So it's important for your puppy to understand that they can be crated even when you are at home, because sometimes, especially when we're working on this potty training, you need your puppy to not be unsupervised, messing around, playing around in the house, and then going and pooping in the corner because you weren't paying attention because you were trying to make dinner or get laundry done. And if your puppy had been crated during that time, even though you're home, that potty accident wouldn't have happened. So you'll again be creating really good habits. And your puppy understands then that they can be crated when you're home, not only when you're away.
Absolutely. So now that we've kind of established a routine is going to be a necessary part of bringing home this new puppy, the next thing that we need to look at is expectations. We want to have expectations of the puppy, and you need to understand that those expectations need to be as close as they're going to be possible to what you're going to expect them out of being. You're going to expect them to be as adults.
Yeah, so we want to have realistic expectations, but have expectations in a sense that we're not making excuses like, oh, they're just a puppy, they'll grow out of this crazy puppy phase.
Yes, so some of those things can be, I expect that our dogs won't jump on us. Now, I can also know that a puppy is going to jump on us. It's
That's
going to
pretty
try
normal.
Those things. That's a normal thing for a puppy to do, and they have to learn. But what we're talking about by setting very specific expectations for your puppy is them knowing that they don't ever get away with that. So if they do try and jump up on you, you're prepared with something, you're distracting them, or you at some point in time move into some form of correction if the distractions ultimately isn't working, but you're going to find some way to say, I am not allowing you to jump on me or other people because we don't want you to do that when you become 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 pounds.
And it's important to remember too that these puppies put their paws up on you, and it's not a big deal when they're a little, you know, 10-pound puppy. And what is our natural tendency? Oh, to pet them. Well, then they're getting positively reinforced for that jumping up behavior. So
yep.
When we want to give them attention, we need to make sure that all four feet are on the ground, as well as let's interact with those puppies that are excitable and full of puppy energy. Let's interact with them as calmly as we can so that they understand, hey, I'm getting developed to understand that I get calm pets and calm attention when I'm acting calmly. I don't have to get riled up and be crazy and wild to get this attention.
Yeah, that's a huge expectation that we have here with our dogs, is they learn from little puppies on that the only attention that they get from Kat and I is calm interaction. We talk about a lot that calm hands make calm dogs, and we show them, this is it. I'm going to rub you, I'm going to scratch your ears, I'm going to do all of these things in this like slower, methodical type,
just mesmerizing, really relaxed.
Everything gets relaxed, and they learn, this is the attention that I get, and they learn to love that. And they learn to feed off of that in a sense of just lean into it. And so that's an expectation that we have with our dogs. Another potentially could be whether you're going to allow your dogs to be on the furniture, whether you're going to allow them to sleep in bed with you, whether you're going to allow them to
leave the kitchen. Some people have specific areas that it's okay for the dog to be in or not to be in. Maybe they're not allowed in the kitchen. Maybe not, they're not allowed down the hallway into the bedrooms. But whatever you decide that you're going to want your adult dog to do, not sleep in bed, not go down the hallway, whatever, not get on the furniture, you have to start setting those expectations
yes.
with your new puppy. It's not like, oh, well, we can cuddle on the couch with the puppy until they're so many months old and then we're done. Well, you just condition them that being on the couch is okay, and it's not fair to change your expectations with them as they get older.
And even from a fairness standpoint, it's not fair to you because you're going to struggle with
yes.
this. You're going to fight it. And you can get as specific as to say, this is a specific chair that you get to stay in, but understand that that's a more advanced thought for them and it's going to take more time and reps. So be patient and be consistent. That is going to be key with your expectations.
And then another expectation that you can have, we were talking about, you know, normal interactions with puppies is to jump up on you. Well, it's also very normal for puppies to explore the world with their mouths, and they have razor sharp little needle teeth. And mm-hmm. so they're going to do some puppy biting.
And razor sharp needle teeth are by design. It's for them to learn what amount of pressure from little puppy on that they should be applying to certain things. So they have to chew on things in order to be able to figure that out.
Yes, but we have to also, again, have expectations, not make excuses and say, oh, well, they'll grow out of this puppy biting phase. Well, they're not going to on their own, so we need to step in and teach them what amount of force is or is not okay to use, because people are very fragile. We have thin skin. We don't want our clothes ripped, that sort of thing. And we also have to let them know that biting is not an okay way to interact with us or even other dogs.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So we've talked about developing a routine, having expectations, knowing what they are and being consistent with them. And lastly,
well, I wanted to throw one last thing in there because we're talking about developing behaviors that we're going to want in our adult dogs.
One last thing,
nail maintenance. That's always a big one. And it's one thing that if you work on consistently with your new puppy, just being comfortable with nail trims and being handled and looked over, for example, like vet appointments, they're gonna wanna look over your dog's physical attributes and give them an exam. The same thing with the nail trims. If they're as comfortable as possible being handled and worked with from day one on, you put them in those positions, you may not trim their nails every day, but you work through that behavior every day, you're going to be so much further ahead than if you say, oh, well, I probably need to start trimming my dog's nails at 5 months, 6 months old. And they're like, wait, 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 we've never done this before. I don't like it. I don't want it. And I'm going to throw a big fit about it. So starting those expectations
yeah.
at the very beginning will be beneficial for you for sure in the long run.
100%. Everything that you're going to expect out of your dog as an adult, you need to start that development process with them as a puppy.
Yes. So now we can get into the last thing.
The last thing, and the third and last thing we're going to be talking about is socialization. You have a new puppy here, and socialization, which is a big buzzword, people hear it all the time. They talk about puppies must be socialized in order to be a good part of society. But what exactly does that mean?
It allows them to be a well-rounded, mentally stable part of society.
And I'm going to say right now, this would be one of those quick moments of Ethan's unpopular opinions or something to that effect.
Brutally honest moments.
There it is. I always get stuck with the BBC's unpopular opinion because he's got a really catchy tune. But my brutally honest comments is I would say a majority of dogs out there are not properly socialized. And you see, from a training standpoint, you see those mental instabilities come out. And granted, our program is set up and designed to help dogs through that and kind of, you know,
build some confidence in themselves,
bridge that gap of what socialization should have happened as a puppy that's kind of not yet. And so that's why our program is set up the way that it is. But if all of those things are being done with your puppies as little puppies, they're much better off to face the world and become hunting dogs and become good parts of society. So
because socialization isn't just, oh, they play with the neighbor kids in the backyard, or they play with our kids in the house. Socialization is any new environment thing, and just being able to adjust to those new things, environments, other dogs, startling experiences, and just react easily and recover quickly. So let's say a plastic bag blew across the front yard and your puppy freaked out. Well, we want them to be...
The first time I saw a plastic bag, I freaked out.
We want them to be able to be like, oh, whoa, that was a little startling, but oh, wait, that's nothing really to be unsure about. And that comes down to new experiences and how we react to our puppy's reaction.
100%.
So if they get startled by something, it's better that you don't go, oh, it's okay, puppy. Don't worry. It's okay, because you're reinforcing their unsure behavior and their unsure mentality about that. They're like, oh, well, mom and dad say it's okay to be unsure of this, so I should be unsure of this. Instead of redirect their focus, you know, they get startled by the bag and then you're like, puppy, 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 and you get them to come to you, and then you're like, oh, good puppy, and you give them some attention for the recall. Yeah. Instead of going over and coddling them that they were unsure of something.
So we've established that socialization is not letting the neighbor kids just play with your puppy. Now that's part of it, but they also need to understand that they need to have the same expectations. You know, you don't want them jumping all over and biting and doing these things with children. So the little kids need to just not be running and screaming. They need to have good manners and behavior. The other side of it's going to be taking them to environments that they're going to have to experience as adults. So take them to fields and take them on car rides, whether that be just to town and back or all of those type of things. Anything that they're going to need to be exposed to as adults, start that exposure early, and it's a lot less traumatic down the road if they're used to it from basically day one.
Yes, and the one little caveat that I'll put in there is before you start interacting your dog with, you know, lots of other dogs, going to dog parks, things like that, you definitely want to make sure your new puppy is fully vaccinated before you go to those areas of high dog density populations. But once you've hit that maybe 16-week mark, depending on your veterinary's recommendations, and fully vaccinated, you should be able to go to those type of places where they can interact again properly with other dogs, as well as just new environments that they're able to explore and learn and train in those situations as well.
Absolutely.
So,
one more thing to add?
No, not this time, do you?
No. Guys, those are the three things that we recommend that you're doing first when you bring your puppy home.
Just to recap, create a routine so your puppy can have expectations of what their day should look like. Next would be developing behaviors that you're going to want in your adult dog. So have fair expectations and don't make excuses that it's just a puppy and they'll grow out of these phases. And then thirdly, and lastly, continued socialization so that you create a well-rounded, mentally stable puppy that's ready to excel at the rest of their lives.
Absolutely. Thanks everybody for watching. Those of you that don't subscribe, or if this is your first time to the channel, definitely hit that subscribe button. It helps us out a lot. I'm the guy with the pink gun.
I'm Kat the dog trainer.
And we'll see you in the next video.